The Pennzoil Truck Series heads to the Vermont International Speedway for its first chase race of season number 8. We're here for the Bass Pro Shops 200, the first of 10 chase races. And this could be a stepping stone for a champion to be crowned for this season. The 23 of Oliver Evans, who comes in as the number 1 seed, is on pole for today's race. Starting beside him in second is the second seed, the 4 of Michael Gregory. Then third place is the fourth seed, Landon Lyons. So the top three go to big chase contenders right here. Fourth place, our first 9 chaser, John Smith. And right at the top 5, another chaser, the 22 of Ryan Robert. And then sixth place, Mathis Wells. Seventh place, the first wild card spot, Jonathan Beaufort. Then eighth, Brian Lee Snare. Ninth place, Danny Bright. And Zachary DeLello, the 07, rounds out the top 10. Back behind them, we have Tyler Fink, who is outside the 2 of Ben Kasperzak, along with Anthony Rodriguez in the 28 and the 11 of Walker Davis. And there's Carson Bowers and Alex Fletcher, the 5, with chaser Leroy Mink comes in as the 3rd seed, and the 57 of Marshall Burrell. And there's Danny Lloyd, who's inside chaser Code Red, along with Anson and Charles Bois, and the 16 of Nonagon Scott. Then there's Riley Spurlytube and 84 of Kyle Hunter. And the 2 chasers, Patrick Smith and Jeff Moses, along with Jordan Stout and Trey Rainey. Then we have Giorgio Sotomu and chaser Nathan Green, along with chaser Freddie Soto and Justin Zeidel, the 17. And there's Kashawn Richardson and Brandon Beal. And the final row starting 35th, chaser Andrew Vance come from the last row. And starting 36th, the final position of the 3 truck of Ray Sir. There is our starting lineup for racing. And our first chase race of the season here at Vermont. Let's go on track sign, fire these trucks up. Six trucks fire their engines up for racing in the first chase race of season number 8 here at the Vermont International Speedway. It's a very interesting 1.5 mile racetrack in order to see the bottom lane work, but here at this racetrack, 2 different lanes can work. Through turns 1 and 2, you want to be on the bottom, but turns 3 and 4, the top lane prevails most of the time. However, the bottom lane can work. Also, the front stretch is a front straight. The back straight has the curve, so that's the back stretch. 21 laps in Vermont. Oliver Evans, Michael Gregory, 2 chasers on the front row, with chaser Landon Lyons back there in third. They come down and take the green flag. We're racing in chase race number 1 of season 8. Wide already. Chaser Oliver Evans leads lap 1. Down to the inside goes Landon Lyons for the top spot into turn 1. He got great push from teammate Jonathan Beaufort. He gets hung up top with Oliver. See, the teammates there kind of swapped. The 22 is the 23's teammate. He's down with the 14, who's the 10's teammate. He's up top with the 23. Bromer trying to get by his teammate Oliver Evans for a second as Landon Lyons leads the race. 3 wide behind them, Tyler Fink and Riley Snare forcing down to the inside for 3rd and 4th. Way up the track for Evans and Beaufort. They come side by side, turn 4 to lead the 2nd lap. Looking Landon Lyons or Ryan Bromer. Lyons has the run off the top. Bromer is the inside lane to the stripe lane, and Lyons leads the 2nd lap of the Bass Pro Shops 200. 3 wide for Tyler Fink. A great move. Tyler Fink, 3 wide to the front. Our non-chaser leads the race. Here comes Riley Snare, another non-chaser, up to 3rd by Michael Gregory, last season's champion. Alex Fletcher, the 5 with Code Red, another chaser, the 33 coming low. And here comes the 1 of Anson and Charles Bois, following through 3 wide. Marshall Burrell in the middle lane, trying to get a nice run with a rotation right there. Bromer tried to get off the corner, but couldn't. Riley Snare moves to the inside of the 6th truck. That's for 2nd position. Tyler Fink leads the 3rd lap of the Bass Pro Shops 300. As Bromer tries to get down front, Snare the 6th, though, has the nose to the inside. Riley Snare to 2nd. Fletcher to 3rd. Here comes Code Red, trying to be the highest chaser right here. With that pass down the backstretch, Code Red now is 12 points. Ryan Bromer, 11. And if Code Red gets up there and wins the race, he gets 3 more bonus points to get 15 total points out of the day. Fink with a great run through the top side clears the 2nd position of Riley Snare. As Code Red looks to come to the bottom. That's for 3rd on Alex Fletcher. Fink the 60 still leads. Riley Snare now 2nd. Fletcher keeps 3rd. Code Red 4th. Anson and Charles Bois moves to 5th. Here comes Jeff Moses, the chaser, up to 6th. Getting by Ryan Bromer. Anson and Charles Bois looking on Code Red. That's for 4th. Has the run down to the inside. Fletcher for 2nd on Riley Snare. Tyler Fink still leads now right to the outside of Fletcher, trying to get a nice rotation there. You get back in the gas on the outside and get that spot. Didn't get a great run though. Snare got a good run in 2nd position onto Tyler Fink. He has a nice drafting run here down the straightaway. Look at Code Red, the push from Ryan Brommer. Is he clear the five? No, Fletcher's still down there. And Anson Charbonneau's gonna look three wide for that spot. That's for third. Three wide. Code Red up top. Fletcher middle, down low. Anson Charbonneau. He has help from two chasers, Jeff Moses and Leroy Minnick. Code Red's clear for third. Got down. Look at the one really slow up the inside. Brommer goes wide to try and avoid that. Here comes Jeff Moses on the outside, getting by the eight, or getting by the one truck. And down low, the 33 Code Red for a second on snare. Gonna try and block out the five of Fletcher. Fletcher top to the inside goes Jeff Moses. Slice and dice move right there. And Code Red to second, getting by Riley Snare, brings chaser Jeff Moses to third. Tyler Fink still leads in the 60 truck. Moses pushing Red, now looking to the inside. The 33 gives him that spot, saying, I'll just get around the outside. Red will actually get down front of that 88, slam the door shut. He has a nice run going. Now to Tyler Fink as they race off turn four. Coming around to complete a third of the race. Seven laps down, 14 to go. Two chasers battle for a second. Jeff Moses and Code Red. They'll bring non-chaser Riley Snare to the battle. Moses, he'll move to second by Red. Now trying to run down Tyler Fink. Snare and Anson Charbois round up the top five. Lee Remick and Alex Fletcher still in the battle for sixth with Kyle Hunter, Danny Bright, and Ryan Brommer just on the edge of this battle. Michael Gregory as well jumps low. He's looking three wide on Kyle Hunter. One of our chasers looking to get up there. Moses looking to get up to Tyler Fink to try and get that spot. He's in the draft in line, but Code Red, is he going to try and pass him out? Red has a nice little run going to the back of the 88. He looks to stay in line for now. Snare as well stays in line in fourth. Fifth place, Anson Charbois has a run onto that six truck. Moses with the run to Fink now for the race lead. Where does Code Red, the 33, go? Look low on the 88. This could help Moses get a nice run off the top of turns three and four to have a shot. Tyler Fink actually get down line in front of the 33. Can he get the run through turns three and four? Hugging that white line, the front three are. Bell for fourth, Anson Charbois inside of Riley Snare. Code Red now for second on Jeff Moses. Nine laps complete. Tyler Fink led a majority of them. Code Red flies to second. Moses did not do well at all on the top of turn one and two. Three wide behind them. It's Lever Mick in the middle. Riley Snare up top. Down low, Danny Brett the 39. So Code Red second. Anson Charbonneau moves to third. Jeff Moses back to fifth as Kyle Hunter looks for fourth. Snare way up top. He'll drop back. Lever Mick a nice run through the middle. But even better run for Danny Brett down low. Anson looked like he was going to make a move onto Code Red, but then Kyle Hunter made a move first. Now he has a chance to go low on that 33 into turn one. He'll look higher. Code Red lower. Staying in line by the 60 of Fink, looking to try and get a push up to him. Now Charbonneau low on Red. It's for second. Has the position down to the inside. See Moses and Danny Bright there battling. Danny wants to get by Jeff, but Jeff wants to stay ahead. Try and run down chaser Code Red. 10 laps to go to the start finish on Code Red. A great run on the top. He'll slice to the inside. Tyler Fink. 10 laps remain. Bound for the lead is on. Code Red inside. Tyler Fink at turn one. And Code Red takes it away. He's out front. Now he's leading now, but no bonus points for the laps to your chaser. So right now, the only point in leading laps is to try and get as many regular season points as you can. Because then, if it comes down to a tie, the ties are broken by whoever has the most full season points at the end of the season. Charbonneau, nice run in second to get to Code Red. Now he'll slice down to the inside of the 33. Back around to the line, nine to go. Code Red leads, but Anson and Charbonneau has a nice run to the bottom of turn one. Here comes Jeff Moses and Michael Gregory, two chasers. Can they get by Code Red here? Moses is second, and right now is the highest chaser points at 12. Michael Gregory looking to do the same, looking for third on Code Red. Pushing Moses, trying to get him clear for second. Moses second, Red back to fourth, and maybe even more as Danny Bright moves inside. Code Red lost all the ground and all the momentum he had just gained the prior lap. See Moses over the back of Anson Charbonneau. Does he make a move down to the inside in turn one? Can he make that move? Michael Gregory fills that inside slot. Michael Gregory to second. Danny Bright for third. Here comes Riley Snare. Three wide behind him as Code Red drops back in the outside. He's looking to try and find a hole down in line now. Ryan Brown moves by him. Fletcher and Kyle Hunter to his inside. Here comes Bowers and Trey Rainey and others. Code Red could fall outside the top 10 by the time he finds a hole down in line. We talked about the outside being well, but if you're up top three wide, that's not going to work at all. Anson Charbonneau leads. Michael Gregory, our chaser, is in second. Last season's truck champion, looking to go back to back. He's won a championship in every series except for the Target Series. He's looking to be the first to win multiple truck championships. He's looking on Charbonneau for the race lead. Danny Bright goes high, looking for a nice run on the top of turns three and four. It could work for him. Watch Danny right here. Can he split the middle? Michael Gregory keeps it tough on the inside. but the one getting the draft from the third, now he'll get back by the four. Here comes Danny Ryder with the run, though. Can he look to the inside turn one? Staying in line behind that one for now. Gregory lost all the momentum he just had. Here comes Danny for the lead now off turn two. Side by side, 2-9, Chasers battle for the top spot in the first chase race of the season. Here comes Chaser Michael Gregory with a nice drafting run onto the back of the 1 and the 39. Here comes Moses down it to the inside on Michael Gregory. That's for 12 points. And Danny Bright, Anthony Trollbar side by side, no one with the help. Snare made contact with Gregory but saved his truck. Trollbar leads with 5 to go, yellow flag will end it, but Danny Bright's the preferred line to turn 1. That inside lane's gonna work for Danny. He's out in front now. Moses looking for 2nd. Right now it's the highest chaser points, so he's in a good spot right now. He couldn't get by the 1 though. Sharpbaugh did a nice job on the top of the turn 22 to only lose 1 spot right there. Normally if you're on the top, you lose maybe 2 or 3. He's gonna hold 2nd as well and have a nice rotation. A big run's gonna be coming right here for the 1. Down to the inside, 4 laps to go. Anson and Sharpbaugh and Danny Bright back side by side. Fletcher low on Jeff Moses. Code Red goes high with the 88. Now Michael Gregory might get forced wide. Trollbaugh back on front over Danny Bright. And Danny only wants one spot there as well. Patrick Smith starting to make his name known. One of our chasers coming back to the front, the 31. 3 wide. Look at Ryan Barmer way up top. That could be 4 wide. That could be dangerous. That could end the race. 4 wide. Tyler Fink gets spun to the inside. He saves his truck. He keeps it green. 3 laps to go in Vermont. Fletcher to 3rd. The front 3 right now, non-chasers. Anson and Trollbaugh, Danny Bright side by side. Non-chaser Fletcher in 3rd. Our highest chaser is 4th place, Jonathan Buford. Where's Buford come from? Our first wildcard spot. He'll push Danny Bright to the inside of the 1 for the race lead. Trollbaugh tries to cut him off. 3 wide now. Jonathan Buford makes the move down to the apron. He's trying to side drive the 3rd and back to him. 2 laps to go in Vermont. The racer at the line is Anson and Trollbaugh with the push from Fletcher. But Danny has the inside in turn 1. 3 wide behind them. Jonathan Buford looking for 2nd on the 1 as Danny Bright clears them off. White flag this time behind the Bass Pro Shops 200. It is about a 5 or 6 truck battle for the top spot. Now what can Danny and Anson do? They're side by side. Anson can run off the top right here but didn't have the momentum to make it work. Danny Bright's in control. Come to the white flag. 1.5 miles to go. Who wins the first chase race of the season? Can Danny Bright hold off chaser Jonathan Buford and Patrick Smith? We're going to find out. Danny a little wide. Buford has a run. Jonathan to the inside. Can he hold it now to the bottom of turns 3 and 4? And can Patrick Smith make a move for the win? Final time in a turns 3 and 4. 3 wide. Patrick Smith makes the move. This is for 15 points. Jonathan Buford, the wild card, holds them off. Back to the checker flag. He'll get 15 points to start the chase. Jonathan Buford wins in Vermont. Jonathan Buford strikes first. He does it. He made in a wild card spot with 2 victories, and he wins the first chase race of the season. How about that? He beats Patrick Smith to the line. That's going to be a great haul for Buford to start the chase out. He's got 4 more points over anyone else in the field. Jonathan Buford wins the Bass Pro Shops 200 in Vermont. Let's go see the finish results and the chase standings after a crazy first chase race. Here are the finish results from the Bass Pro Shops 200 at the Vermont International Speedway. No caution flags today and 8 lead changes, 7 drivers leading here today in Vermont. It was a very interesting race at the front, and winning it at the end, chaser Jonathan Buford got in on a wild card spot in the chase and he strikes first, getting the most points of 15 to start the chase. Second place finisher, another chaser, Patrick Smith, got the 2nd wildcard spot. So our 2 wildcard drivers doing the best here today, finishing 1st and 2nd, battling for the win at the end. And when we thought about this whole format with the whole winners get more points, never used to be like that. Last season was the first season we did that. When it was thought about that, the whole point was to encourage chasers to go out there and try and win races. We saw Patrick Smith make a big 3 wide move into turn number 3 here to try and win the race and get those bonus points. Would he maybe not have done that if it were a prior format where he's like, I'll just take the points I get? Instead, he saw 4 more points in the line from him. He said, I'm going to go for it, and almost got to John Buford there because stuck it to the bottom of turn number 3. Trollbaugh, Bowers, and Kyle Hunter rounded the top 5. Anson Trollbaugh had a great trucker today, led 6 laps. Tyler Fink led 9 of the 21 laps, the most of anyone. He ends up in 6th. 7th place, Danny Bright. 8th place, Alex Fletcher. Kashawn Richardson in 9th, and rounded the top 10, the 4 truck of Michael Gregory. So how about at the beginning of the race, we had so many chasers start up in the front. We had four of the top five were chasers, and some more inside the top 10 as well. When we end the race, only three chasers finish inside the top 10. 11th place goes to Anthony Rodriguez. Oliver Evans started on pole but finishes 12th. Never really had the race pacer today to keep up. Brandon Beal gets 13th, Marshall Burrow 14th, and Ryan Lee Snare 15th. For a while there, it looked like Kodar was going to be the highest finishing chaser, but he got shelved back, never could recover, 16th. Same with Jeff Moses in 17th. Ryan Brimer gets 18th. He was very quiet all race long. 19th place to Ray Sir, and Mathis Wells 20th. 21st place for Georgios Otumbo, 22nd Levi Manick, 23rd Walker Davis, 24th for Jordan Stout, 25th Nathan Green. Then Freddie Soto, 26th, Landon Lyons, 27th. He really dropped in the later laps of this race. He was up front a little bit early on. 28th place, Nygaard Scott, 29th, Trey Rainey, 30th, Zachary DeLello, 31st, Danny Lloyd, 32nd, John Smith, 33rd for Ben Kasperzak, 34th, Andrew Bean, our lowest finishing chaser, and Justin Liddell, 35th, with Riley Spirito finishing 36th here today. At the right side are the point standings. With it just being the first race, it's basically where everyone finished. Obviously, John Spieffer with the additional points is now 4 points ahead. He's our points leader. Following him is Patrick Smith, then Michael Gregory, Oliver Evans, Code Red, along with Jeff Moses, Ryan Brommer, Levi Minnick, Nathan Green, Freddie Soto, Landon Lyons, and Andrew Bean. So right now, it's very, very simple. Once we start getting in three, four races, we'll start to know who's maybe used up some mulligans and who has a shot to try and do better as we go further into this 10-race chase. So after a crazy first chase race at a very unique racetrack, we're going to another unique racetrack for the second chase race. We're going racing at the 1 Mile Oval in Boston. It's the Boston International Speedway, the White Castle 250. I will see you guys then.